live from Newark, New Jersey, we welcome you to another edition of ZCW Destruction. Hello there, everyone. My name is Zaiah Morgan. I am your official commentator here for ZCW. And what a show we have planned for you as we are just moments away from ZCW Fuel. And as you can see tonight, we've got a number one contender match for the ZCW Women's Tag Team title, as Io Shirai and Toni Storm look to take on the Vincent of Carnage, but Mikasa still not here. Will Tia have a new partner? We will see. Also, we will see Diana Perrazzo return to ZCW action later tonight as well, as she competes in singles competition. Her and Lauren are now at an official unit. God knows what else is going to happen. Seth Rollins also looking to compete later tonight after his complete decimation of his last opponent, now looking to do the same, to send another message to James Needham later tonight. We're going to see what the Visionary has in store. Also, we're going to hear from Darren Payne for the first time in months. We already know who he has his sights set on, but we're gonna find out how he is going to proceed in doing so. But also in our main event, it will be Adam Cole Bebe taking on the mayor of the Violence Park, Malik Brown. In single competition, Malik wanted a chance to prove himself. He's going to get that chance by going up against one of the best wrestlers in the world. But there you can see the man that made his return on the last episode of Destruction. He is none other than the Blood Wolf himself, Darren Payne. The man that was screwed back at ZCW Turmoil in that six-pack challenge when Walter, our new ZCW World Champion, put a chair to his back and cost him the chance to become ZCW World Champion. No, Payne has not forgotten that night. He has not forgotten that moment. And he proved so when he attacked Walter on the last episode to close out the last episode. And now we open up with the Blood Wolf. Well, we heard Payne just bring up the ZCW World Championship, and I think this man might have a little something to say about that. The former ZCW World Champion himself, and the man who will be facing Walter in a rematch come ZCW Fuel, it is none other than Sami Zayn. Payne mentioned that Walter had beaten another man behind his back to get the belt, and that man is that man right there. Back when the lights went out and the oppression was taken out, Sami Zayn was choked out by Walter, but no, now look at this, Zayn getting in the face of the Blood Wolf. This is going to get interesting. Thank you. Oh boy. As if this whole situation wasn't interesting enough. Here comes the leader of the end and a former ZCW World Champion in his own right, Luke Khan. We know for months now Luke Khan has been trying to figure out who it was that attacked the Oppression back at Devastation. And it still looks like he hasn't gotten any answers or gotten any closer to finding an answer, but I feel like there's a reason why he's coming out here and why he's specifically coming out here while both Zayn and Payne are out. Oh boy. Oh, here we go. Oh boy. Whoa, wait a minute. I think I recognize that voice. And yep, there he is, the current ZCW World Champion. Walter now making his way at least towards the ramp here. Walter making it pretty clear that it doesn't matter who stands in his way. He is planning on walking away the ultimate victor, leaving with two world titles. But will that be the case? We're going to have to find out and see. I can tell you one thing, this whole thing has just gotten way out of hand. Gorilla Black basically laying down the gauntlet, throwing out the challenge to Archer, even tossing in the ZCW Megaton Championship in the middle of it. Will Archer accept? I can't imagine he won't, but we're going to have to wait and see. Because right now we are getting ready for our first match of the night. It is one of the two qualifying matches that are taking place to find out who will fight for that number one contenders match at the ZCW Fuel for the ZCW Tag Team titles. This all coming off of the news that the Tag Team Warfare Tournament had to be canceled, properly scheduled for another later time. But as it is, ZCW General Manager Mack Waters has made it clear that he is putting four of the top contenders in the ZCW Tag Team Division in matches. We will have a match here on Destruction and then a match on Unlimited. And then the two winners of those matches will face at ZCW Fuel in the number one contenders match for the ZCW Tag Team titles. As here you can see FI4K, who have been on quite the roll. They've only lost one match ever since the start of the new season, and that was to the Tag Team Champions, the new scene, back at Devastation. However, the team that they are facing, well, they've got a bit of a track record here as well in ZCW. Here comes the first participant, the current ZCW Pride Champion. It is none other than Xander. Xander, the current ZCW Pride Champion, defended that belt against Pac back at Devastation. He was originally supposed to be in that Tag Team Warfare Tournament with Zaiah Steel, but now is competing in this qualifying match to see if they can move on to ZCW Fuel. Xander and Steel are no strangers to the Tag Team titles. They started out in ZCW as a tag team. People seem to forget that. And now with them in the fall with Cody Barnett, God only knows where that man is at this point, but nonetheless, Xander and Zaiah Steel, they have a great track record as a tag team here in ZCW. We even fought for the tag team titles back at This Day We Fight, back when Payne and Corbin were still tag team champions. And speaking of tag team champions, here comes a man that just recently won a tag team champion not too early this month, or last month I should say. He is none other than the Prince of Death, the never-ending threat, and one half of the Call All-Stars World Tag Team Champions. He is none other than Zaiah Steel, the co-champions with his tag team partner Malik Brown, part of Sovereign Death Machine. What was a shocker to a lot of people when they actually won the belts from the East Coast Connection back to the last World Tour special. But you can basically also chalk that victory up thanks to one Sean Walsh for getting involved in that match, but that is neither here nor there. The fact of the matter is this, is that Zaiah Steel has been on quite the roll ever since coming back as the Prince of Death. Ever since then, he has made it very clear that he is looking for belts. He is looking for gold here in ZCW. Is the one thing that has eluded him throughout his career in ZCW. Oh! He's been here since day one and he is still yet to win a championship in ZCW. That could all change though. Him and Xander can win this match and go on to Fuel. See if they can become number one contenders for the ZCW Tag Team Championship. This match gets started. We're starting off with Chris Guerra and Xander. As Guerra now, snapmare takeover. Tries to go for a drop kick. Xander though, getting back to his feet. Arm drag, takedown. Going off the ropes here. Drop toe hold. This match already coming into a fast start here. Look at this happen. Half suplex. Not wasting any time, going straight out the gate. is a tag. To Trent Sky, Chris Renner now, draw toe hold, double foot stomp to the back of the head, and a knee to the side of it. We're seeing that excellent tag team offense on full display by FI4K. One, two. No, FI4K would love nothing more than to get back in the mix for the ZCW tag team titles. Considering how close they came last time when they went up against the new scene. You can only think that if they were able to get a rematch, who knows, the new scene's days as champions might be numbered, and FI4K might have, you know, the game plan and the strategy next time in order to get those belts. Oh my goodness, but do they have the strategy in order to beat the fall here tonight? Now Xander is in control after that. Into Geary, into the corner. As Trent Sky drops him with the running knee. Nora hooks both legs but is unable to get the three. Xander now taking Trent into his own corner. Looking for a tag out to steal here. The first time this match, big time avalanche. Oh my goodness gracious! An assisted hip attack. Courtesy of Xander and Steel there. Now we get to see Vea Steel eagle for the first time in this contest. And he's dropping almost all of his weight on the neck of Trent Sky there. Older, much more calculated side from Steel than we've ever come to see from him here in ZCW. He's always been a hard-hitting competitor, no doubt, but it seems that he's relishing in the pain and in the punishment he delivers onto his opponents now. You can see he's now stomping a mud hole into Trent Sky. All this pain and punishment. Now look at this, he's just taunting Chris Ware, who is begging for a tag at this point, but Trent trying to get himself back to his feet and only gets met with a kick to the midsection and a shining dark courtesy of the Prince of Death. Already now looking for the victory here. There's the two. This time, Trent is able to kick out. Now you can see Steel putting the knee in the back. He's got a single leg Boston Crab, or a single leg Camel Clutch, I should say, being applied here in the middle of the ring. This guy getting out of it. Big time kicks to the head. He might be knocking. Wait a second. Oh! Trent Sky now finding some life. Might have found his second wind here. Big time clothesline. That's the one. There's a thrust kick. Taking down Zaiah Steel. FI4K are in control. Or as soon as I say that, there's a back elbow. Whoa. This delirium did. Zaiah Steel gets caught with the pop-up drop kick. Straight to the top of the head. Steel is in trouble. Tag out to Wera. FI4K going to do what they do best in that show. Excellent chemistry. The Enziguri knee smash combo followed up with the Northern Light suplex with the leg hook, and it's still only good enough for a two. But now Guerra has the right idea. Keeping on the pressure, going to the Hybrid District and hits a frog splash. Hooks the leg again, but it's still only good enough for a two count. Steel is reeling here. FI4K might actually have the chance. No. It's out of it. It's still just dropping Wera right on his head. Oh, now you can see Steel might be a bit frustrated. I don't know. It seems like he might have lost his cool there. Now with this Spine Buster, and a Frog Splash from Xander to Wera. Will this be enough? No. I have to say, even though... Oh my goodness, complete shot. Wera never even saw it coming. And it's still weakened for a two. I was going to say, despite Xander and Steel not normally teaming up nowadays in ZCW, they are working as a well-oiled machine, at least for right now. Drop down, gets out of the bow and arrow. Wera now looking to capitalize. Has both shoulders down here. Only gets a two count. Xander now in trouble as Wera has him hooked up for that straight jacket backbreaker. No. Wera hitting him with that signature backbreaker. Now looking to pick up Xander. No, big time uppercut. Wait a minute, look at this armbar, shape of Blue Justice, Yuji Nagata. Could be looking to snap that arm. Wera pushing Xander away. Whoa. Xander now. With the roll up the two, no. Couldn't get it there. But look at this, Wera running right into the like clockwork DDT. Down goes Trinsky. Looking the lag, does Xander, and this one is over. The fall. Xander and Zaiah Steel are moving on to Fuel, and they will be in the number one contenders match. See who will face for the ZCW Tag Team Championship at a later date. A high-octane battle, to say the very least. Two teams that know each other very well, showing it right here in this contest. You see the excellent tag team maneuvers that went on throughout the entirety of this match. Xander still winning this one. And the next Unlimited show will be the end of Yucatan and Micah taking on the Cash Money Hooligans of Jay Roberts and Trevor Diaz. The winner of that match will take on the fall at ZCW Fuel. You can see the light clockwork DDT and Xander putting this one away very swiftly. So there it is, your first team to make it to the number one contenders match at Fuel. We'll find out if they will be fighting the end or the Cash Money Hooligans at ZCW Unlimited. But for right now, it seems that the fall has successfully, at least for now, taken one of the top spots back in the tag team division. Vanessa saying that she will accept Adeline's challenge for a match, but only if she's able to beat Samantha Hart in a no disqualification match in the next edition of Unlimited. Don't tell me that Adeline would not be afraid to take that challenge, but I don't know. I don't trust that stipulation as long as the Masterclass is throwing it out, but we'll have to get that at a later time. We've got more action coming your way, this time singles competition in the women's division, as here comes a returning Deonna Purrazzo, the champ, the current Ring of Honor women's champion, and Reina de Reyes champion as well. The Virtuosa has successfully made her way back to ZCW, and she's got, unfortunately, she's got a partner now with her in the form of the Canadian Amazon, Lauren Richfield. Here we go. The Fae taking on Deonna. Deonna working over the arm. Oh my goodness gracious. One thing that Deonna excels at, it's the technician side. She gets a hold of that arm. That does not spell good news for you, but look at this. LaFay actually trying to turn it around on Deonna. No, that did not. That was not a smart decision. Don't try to outsmart the Virtuosa. It rarely goes well for you as, oh my goodness, LaFay almost got her jaw knocked into the second row there. And now we get to see the vicious side of Deonna right now. Going right back after that arm. Oh my goodness gracious. She might have just tore her shoulder and popped it out of socket. Now Deonna taking LaFay and just putting her into the corner. You have to think that somewhere Frieza and Beryl are watching this one very closely. After Beryl got screwed out of her singles match with Lauren Richfield back at Devastation, where Deonna would make her return. Nice to the one off of the force court, two, only getting a two. LaFay trying to fight back here at least. Big time forearms, even with the hurt arm, she's trying to fight back. Going off the ropes, it just gets dropped with the German suplex. Now you can see her clutching at her head here. Deonna in full control. I don't know, what in the hell? Is this like a leg sweep DDT? Dropping LaFay right on her head. She could be looking for that Fujiwara armbar right here in the middle of the ring. LaFay's got nowhere to go, and yeah, she's got a tap. A dominant victory for Deonna Purrazzo in her return to ZCW. The Virtuosa coming in full force and just completely taking over this match. Look at this, German suplex right on LaFay's head. As if that wasn't enough, the leg sweep DDT followed by the Fujiwara armbar. The Virtuosa reigns supreme. And with Lauren at her side, only one to wonder what these two are going to do here in ZCW. Now that they have successfully joined, wait a damn minute. Here comes Bell and here comes Priza. We knew that this was going to happen sooner or later. And then successful. Oh, now look at that. Both women leaving when things were just starting to get interesting. I have a feeling that they can only duck these two for so long before something's gotta give here. Lauren and Deanna have made their beds, and they're at one point, and on one day, they're gonna have to sleep in them. And I can guarantee you, Beryl and Priest will have no problem on trying to make sure that actually happens. But for right now, Deanna and Lauren get to make their escape for another day, but Judgment Day is coming. Trying to pick a fight with the general manager. That was never going to end well. And Matt just pretty much laying down the law for a current ZCW world champion. He is not in control. There's only one person running the show here, and it ain't him. Right now, we've got more singles competition. Now, here comes, oh, come on. No. It's Nathan, God damn it. Well, there's the visionary himself, Seth Rollins. We saw what he did last time on Destruction to Daniel McCabe. And now he's looking to do the same to Nathan Morgan here. We heard Rollins the last time. He said he's going to continue to hurt as many people on this roster as it, until he gets a response from Needham. He is looking to do this to send a message to Needham. Saying if he decides to show his face again, that this is what he is coming back to. Rollins at this point has just completely gone off the damn deep end. Oh my goodness gracious, the Falcon Arrow on the concrete. Say that this man has lost the plot would be an understatement. Oh my goodness. Any sense of morality or any of that has just completely gone out the window with Seth. Now the referee has no choice but to actually legitimately start the match here. As now Seth just hangs Nathan up to dry. Seth now standing moonsault. Nathan is barely responding. Seth is still not down. He is still just bleeding away at Nathan Morgan. Nathan is didn't even have time. He was completely blindsided And now Seven is just dishing out more pain, more punishment. There's nothing Nathan can do here. It's not a wife. Seth now has Nathan Morgan. Oh my goodness gracious! Let's not forget, Nathan is a former ZCW Tag Team Champion. One of the longest in this company's history. And he's being toyed with by this absolute nut job. Now what is Seth doing? Where in the hell are you going? As if... Oh, no. Table! Is back! Bouncing off that announced table padding! And Seth stopping the count. Purposefully stopping the count. Just to do more damage. Come on, Seth's been done enough. As if one wasn't bad enough. Right on the LED post and on the deadly padded floor. Are you kidding me? He's looking to destroy the spine of Nathan Morgan. The worst part is there's not a damn thing anybody can do to stop it. Now he's got him lined up. There's a super kick. Nevada Kedavra. You can just see him. You know what he's signaling for. Nathan can barely move. Now Seth lines him up. There's the damn curb stomp. He's not even going for the cover. As if this wasn't bad enough. Nathan is still trying to get to his feet, but oh my gosh. Come on, Seth. Come on, you're done enough! A second damn curb stomp. Mercifully, this one's over. A disgusting display from Rollins here. And absolutely unnecessary. The lengths that this man is willing to go to in order to send a message. There is no justifying what Seth just did here. He could have won this match after the first curb stomp, but decided to add insult to injury. Seth gets the victory here tonight. He looks to further sending a message to Needham by destroying anyone in his path, and then showing him that this is the only thing you have to look forward to if you dare to show your face again. Absolute sickening display from Rollins. All right, come on. Enough, Seth, you've done enough. You've done damn well enough. Come on, now shit, the match is over. The match is over. Oh my goodness. This is absolutely ridiculous. We might actually need to get security down here because only God knows what this man is planning to do now. No. Okay, we need someone to get out here. He is gonna break this man's neck. Wait a damn minute, that's Needham! There's Needham! James Needham is back! And he's finally here! To kick this psychopath's ass! Rollins being ping-ponged back and forth between the barricade and Needham. looking to stop Seth Rollins' tyranny. Pirate, no! Seth getting out of it, now Seth getting out of Dodge. Like the damn coward he is. He wanted to meet, he said that Nina, he was gonna send Nina a message, but it seems like the only message that Rollins got is that Nina ain't going anywhere. Which is very, very bad news if your name is Seth Rollins.
The day that someone takes those belts off of those two Neanderthals would be the day I celebrate. Possibly more, than when I become engaged. But that's neither here nor there. It is now time for our number one contenders tag team match for the ZCW Women's Tag Team titles. Out first, none other than Toni Storm, and there's her tag team partner, Io Shirai. Now this one is very interesting because Storm and Io have obviously been having their issues with the Vixens of Carnage, Mikasa and Kia Schultz. However, Storm has also had a problem with another woman, but will not mention her at this time. But Toni Storm, Io Shirai, getting ready for this number one contenders tag team contest. Here's the interesting part, though. We already saw Toni Storm take out Mikasa on the last episode of Destruction. And from what I've heard, Mikasa is still not here. Mikasa has still not been found. So is Tia just gonna, is this a handicap match now? Did Tia find a partner, is what I'm getting at here. I guess we're just gonna have to wait and find out. You can hear the music, you can hear the pyro as well. See the crowd on their feet as the lights go out, and in comes Tia Schultz, one half, I should say one third of the Vixens of Carnage, along with Casa and Alicia Schultz, also a holder of the CCL Breakthrough Women's Championship at one point. Was looking to become the new number one contender with her nephew and one Mikasa Schultz, but obviously, as I just explained, that's not happening. So again, it all comes down to the fact, is Tia gonna have to be a one woman army going into this match? I mean, knowing Toni and Io, that's probably not the smartest thing to do. But we know how hard-headed those Schultzes are, so it would not surprise me if he had just decided to go this match alone. Tia Schultz, an accomplished tag team and singles wrestler, there's no doubt, but I don't think she can win a singles tag team battle. Especially when that tag team is in the form of Io Shirai and Toni Storm, two of the best women's wrestlers on the planet today. However, we know that Tia is not going to back down from this challenge. We know that she was going to come here no matter what, so now it just comes down to what is the game plan here. No! No, are you kidding? You can't be so... Are you kidding me? I should have figured something like this was gonna happen. Alright. Saving the blind rage for another day. Well, it looks like Tia has, I guess, found herself a tag team partner. Because, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the newest member of the ZCW roster, thanks to what happened back at Fandom Takeover, it is now Roxy Cush Hayes. And like I mentioned earlier, that Storm was having a problem with another person, and that person who didn't used to be signed here, but I guess now is. Thanks for that, Jackpot. Roxy Kush Haze has been a thorn in the side of Toni Storm for long. And if you look at Toni right now, it looks like she's about to blow a gasket. She's not happy about this. So Roxy Kush Haze making her return back to a ZCW ring. Now it's teaming up with Tia to see if they can become the new number one contenders for the ZCW Women's Tag Team titles. See the push the cush section in the audience is well in effect here. I'll never understand it, but the people love this woman.
Well, here we go! Io and Tia starting this match off. We're not even going to bother with the collar and elbow tie. We're going straight into the action. Forearms flying aplenty. Off the ropes. Oh my goodness gracious! Standing shining wizard from Io. Out of nowhere. Tia kicking out at one though. Off the ropes. Does Io Shirai but gets caught. Whirl around neck breaker. Tia now looking for drop kick. Io getting out of the way. Io now with the roll up here. Shoulders down. That's a kick out there for Tia. And now going off the ropes. Whoa, Tia Schultz now with the Marufuji. That's his takedown. And Tia Schultz in firm control. Now Io trying to get back to her feet. And now what in the hell? Oh my goodness, sit out! Implant DDT. Now Tia Schultz, Tiger Suplex, dropping Io right on the back of her head, only gets a two count. Tia now tagging out to Roxy Kush Haze. Standing corkscrew moonsault and a big gal senton from Roxy. Io currently getting worked over by Tia and Roxy at the moment. This match not already... That's not going well over 2 minutes, and already Tia and Roxy showing some chemistry. Will that be enough? We still got a lot more match to go. Tia going off the ropes. Gets caught again, this time with the Frankensteiner. Courtesy of the Kush. Now Roxy again. Oh, tilt a whirl head scissors. Io Shirai being taken for a ride. Oh, wait a second. Roxy's not paying attention. That gave Io enough time to get the tag out to Toni, and now you can see Toni Storm. Oh, she's been waiting for this one. Months and months. I wouldn't say attacks, but just aggravating her from the crowd or by ringside, and Toni Storm has finally had enough. Now just wailing on Roxy Kush Haze here. I think she's starting to see red, and I think the number one contender spot is kind of looking secondary here. She's just looking to beat the hell out of Roxy. I don't know, that might cost her. She might want to get refocused here. Toni Storm now has her up in the air. Super, no. Roxy! Dropping her. They're Roxy. Oh no. I've seen this before. Roxy Kush is looking for the People's Moonsault. Hits it perfectly for the victory, only giving a two count so far, but Toni Storm feeling the brunt of that moonsault across the sternum. Roxy though gets caught. Dragon screw leg whip for Toni Storm. Now I think the tag team champions, B&B Incorporated, KCB and Tia Benson, now looking at this match, very interested in what the outcome is going to be. Sent to the outside is Roxy Kush Haze. Toni Storm now taking her off the apron. Storm could be looking for strong zero already. No! Sunset flip! On the outside, Roxy now looking for something. Oh, wait a second. Toni catching her with the pop-up German suplex right on her back, right on that thinly padded floor. And that's not good news if you're the Kush. You're feeling every bit of that. It's now Toni kicked to the leg, and there's a shining wizard straight to the head of Roxy Kush Hayes. Nice looking in the corner, tag out to Io. Toni now has her. There's the hip toss and a double sandwich kicks from Toni and Io. Roxy getting back to her feet, but Io Shirai is on the apron with the missile drop kick. The springboard missile drop kick straight to the chest, and T was able to break it up. But gets German for her troubles. Roxy could be in a lot of trouble now. Partner has been taken out effectively in this match. There's the standing moonsault. Io looking to get it right here, right now. Roxy able to get out of it. Io now grabbing her by the back of the head, sending her into the A-ball. Accidentally almost caught Toni there. But look at this. Zaiah flip! Powerbomb! Her spine being driven into the mat. I would not be surprised if this one was close to being over after that. I don't know how anyone can recover. There's a tag out to Toni. And now look at this. Kush being driven into the corner. It gets met with a forearm. Toni Storm. And now working over the leg of Roxy Kush Hayes. You know what? Toni again just working over the legs of Roxy here. Completely slowing down the Kush. Toni going to show off here with the Romero special. Roxy in a lot of trouble here. As you can see, Toni just stretching her out high up in the air. Referee doing a good job checking on Roxy, looking for a verbal submission here. Oh, wait a second. No. Roxy gets out of it, but Toni already back on offense. Sends her into the corner. Missed with the drop kick. And now Roxy with the float over DDT. And you can see Storm trying to get back to her feet. She's still rocked up. But here comes Roxy Kush Hayes with the Bulldog. The running Bulldog. Catching Storm off guard. And now, can she get the tag out? Yes, she can. No one now is this. The drop to hold, elbow drop, and guess what? It never fails. And oh my goodness, that's vintage Tia Schultz with the spike DDT. Now Tia looking to get something going for her team. There's a knee. And a follow up with a Bulldog of her own. Colin Storm back to her feet. Tia Schultz looking for something here. Big time! Tornado kick! Clocking Storm right on the top of her head. Will this be enough? No! Oh my goodness gracious. The signature tornado kick. And now Tia, no, gets caught. No, she doesn't! Captain kick to the top of the dome. Has her looking for the suicide solution. dropping Storm face first. And now Tia looking to go up top. Calling Toni Storm to her feet. And now, oh, wait a second. Oh! She saw Io coming. Decided to make a dive for it. Storm getting out of the way. And now, Tia Schultz paying for that mistake. Followed up with a powerbomb after the German suplex. Will this be enough? No, it will not be. As again, Tia was able to kick out of it. Now again, another German suplex. Storm could be looking to finish right about now. Into the corner, tag out to Io here. Snapmare and a giant boot to the face of Tia Schultz. And now Tia planted with a reverse DDT. Going into the corner, Io could be looking for the moonsault. No! Io was looking for the moonsault. Nobody, yo! And now look at this! Tia Schultz with the reverse figure four being applied. And now Io Shirai, the one in trouble. Referee asking what Io wants to do here, but Io is able to escape. Gets out of the hole. Ah, oh, there's another standing shining wizard. Tia ran right into it. Could be looking to call it up. Tiger fake kick. Oh, wait a second. Roxy getting involved. Roxy helping out her tag team partner, but now look at Io. Dropping her with the body slam. And now, where are Tia Schultz with the missile front kick to the back? Io never saw it coming. And now she's just going in on the Joshi Judas. Oh my goodness. Into the corner. Tag out to Roxy. Looking for something here. Oh my goodness. Buckle bomb into Geary. Combination. Hooks the leg. Does Roxy. Two. No. Only a two count still. Oh, but Roxy's feeling it. It could just be a matter of time. No, Io with the reversal. All this to see who fight Casey and Tia for those tag team titles at Fuel. All right, we're getting out of the way. Io getting planted into the mat. Big time smack across the face. And now look at this. Tiger suplex from Roxy. That tiger suplex coming from out of nowhere. But now look at Io completely rocked. Code red. Two. No. How much more? Why are these? Oh no, wait a second. Toni trying to get involved, trying to go for that back elbow, but Roxy saw it coming. And now look at this, Storm with the half axe suplex. Tia though, getting involved. Look at this. Blood rising. Oh gosh. Blood rising brainbuster. Io Shirai. Butterfly backbreaker. Both Tia and Toni have been taken out. Io's looking to finish. No! Big time forearm. Completely rocked Io. And now, hit the bomb! Onto Io Shirai. Roxy with the pin. Roxy got it! Roxy has successfully got the victory, and her and Tia are going to fight for the tag titles. And Toni cannot believe it. The look on her face, the look of shock. That just happened. Look at this. Hit the bong. Right on Io Shirai's head. And Storm could do nothing but look on. As Roxy had gotten the one up on her again. So it will be at Fuel. BFB Incorporated taking on this team of Tia and Roxy. I'm still not sure what to make of this, but to say that this isn't at least a bit interesting would be an understatement. Oh boy, here come the champs. We got one unlikely duo fighting a completely another unlikely duo. This is going to be a very, very interesting battle come Fuel, to say the very least. was much interesting counter, to say the least. But we've got a match card to run down for the next episode of ZCW Unlimited. The last episode before we get to ZCW Fuel. We'll be hearing from James Needham himself, the Precision Pirate, will be there, and he will be looking to address his issues with Seth Rollins, as well as what I've heard is issuing issues of a challenge strong as well. We'll also see the last qualifying match, he will fight the fall for the number one contender spot at the ZCW Fuel, as well as the cash money duel against J-Rob Trevor Diaz, taking on the end of Luka Khan and Micah. In an interesting, very interesting battle, Adelaide White Winter has accepted. She will take on Samantha Hart in a no disqualification match. And if Adelaide can beat Samantha, not only will she get a match, she'll get to choose the stipulation and when and where that match will take place. And of course, in our main event, it will be Walter taking on Jamal Bedlam for the CCL World Championship. This one boiling over after all the attacks, after all the back and forth, we finally get to settle it between the Ring General and the Savage. We'll also be running down the match card for Fuel on the next coming Unlimited. So stay tuned. You do not want to miss this jam-packed episode of Unlimited. But it is now time for our main event of that evening. As right now, making his way down to the ring, it is none other than Adam Cole, baby. This match was made thanks to the words of one Malik Brown on the last edition of Unlimited, where Malik, after realizing he's been kind of hasn't been on the winning side of things of the lane, he's decided he wanted another chance, another challenge, prove himself. He threw it to Matt Walter. He said, give me anyone, give me any single person on this roster that will give me a fight. And well, I think Waters has done chosen a damn good pick in the form of Adam Cole, one of the best wrestlers on the face of the planet today. You're looking to take on Mayor of the Violent Party, the one half of the Call All-Stars Tag Team Champions. And this man right here. Brown making his way down to the ring after two failed attempts against one of the likes of John Moxley. Blake realizing that he has been on a bit of a cold streak. This cannot be denied. It is going to take some time to find himself completely, but with that, he's going to find that one man that he truly once was during his time here at ECW. He has to face up against the best. He knew that he couldn't just face any other person. He had to go up against someone with that sort of record, with that sort of resume, that would get Malik noticed back again in the world title picture. And hopefully in doing so would send a bit of a message to Moxie whenever he decides to pop back up in ZCW. Next time around, next time that these two meet, it will not be the same song and dance. Malik has to prove that to himself and to these people here tonight, going up against the likes of Adam Cole, who has only sustained one loss here in ZCW. Here we go. This is your main event for ZCW Destruction number 5. It is Adam Cole taking on Malik Brown in singles competition.
right now. Call right now. They're tie up in the middle of the ring. And Cole locking in. That side headlock down Malik. Gonna toss him off the ropes, but gets caught completely by Adam Cole. That's the thing with Cole, he's not afraid. Oh gosh, to try to get in your head, but one thing Cole probably shouldn't try to do, and that's try to match strikes with Malik Brown. That's just a battle you're not gonna win. I know that Cole has that dangerous super kick that he can hit at any time, but we know that Malik Brown has an assortment of strikes that could end the match, especially with that jack wire knee. One thing that Cole has to be wary about, try to go for a forearm, but now Malik striking back with forearms of his own. Kick to the leg, oh, isn't he? Caught the kick, but did he catch that? Aims at Geary to the back of the head. You can see Malik getting himself all fired up after that. Malik now has Cole provide neckbreaker. So far, Malik in firm control of this matchup. Especially with Ben only getting a one count off of the provide. Uppercut stuns Cole here. Sends him into the corner. Now, machine gun, light chops, shades of Kenta Kobashi. Well, he's making one more. And there's one for flinching. Cole now being taken to task here. Look at this. Michinoku driver from Malik. As now Malik going up top, looking for a moonsault. No, lands on his feet. But oh gosh, a drop kick, a basement drop kick from Cole, completely catching Malik off guard and followed up with the neck breaker. Cole now going for the pin. Gets the half. Only get the one count though. Cole did the smart thing in targeting that leg as soon as possible. And now, making sure he stays on the offense. I'm going to try to pull the hamstring of Malik Brown as we see. He's just... Now again going after that leg. You can see that Malik is grabbing at the thigh there. Now Cole has him once again. Big time scoop and a slam as we set up here. Cole now going off the ropes. One could only wonder what in the world he's thinking of here, and he locks in a chin lock. That right there is classic Adam Cole, baby. Malik now struggling to get out of this. Oh, goodness, there's a jawbreaker for good measure. Have shot to the chest, and another one fighting back against Cole. Gotta go for a kick. Gets caught with the dragon screw leg whip. Luke trying to regain his bearings here, trying to get back to his feet, but Cole already back on the assault. Stopping a mud hole, rocking the drive with Malik Brown. Looking to hear it from these fans here in ZCW. Wait a second, Malik now. Irish up in the corner. Nope, missed the drop kick. Cole now going off the ropes, but now Malik catching him with the German suplex, smashing the back of his head into the canvas. Malik now going for the cover, hooks the leg. Will this be enough? No. You know that Cole has been having his issues as of late with Pac. I mentioned that one loss that Cole had, it came by the hands of Pac during that mini ZCW Pride Championship tournament. Pac screwed Cole. Oh my goodness gracious, what strikes with slaps there from Malik. As now Malik might be, well, I thought he was going to try to go for the violence party, but instead goes for the sliding D instead. Right to the jaw of Cole. Will that be enough? No, it will not, at least not yet.
loss. It was too cocky, even though Pac had to go into devious tactics in order to get that victory. Low pull and screwed him out of that match and screwed him out of the Canada fight for the ZCW Pride Championship as well. You know, Cole has not forgotten that. He attacked Pac on the last episode of Destruction. But now look at this. Malik Brown keeping all the pressure with the Suicide Tornado DDT. Spiking, absolutely spiking Adam Cole on the top of his head. Now one can only imagine what Malik could have planned. Cole as he smashes him back and forth between the barricades here. The referee is still counting. But I don't think Malik Brown really cares as he just delivers a hard knee straight to the head of Cole. At a count of seven here, Malik now looking to bring Cole back into the ring. Cole could be knocked for a loop, and Malik's not making it any better. More knees to the side of the head, courtesy of Malik Brown. And now Malik looking for the Anaconda Vice. Anaconda Vice looking to choke out Cole. Could be looking to put Cole to sleep here. Referee asking Adam what he wants to do. No, knees to the back. Into the back. There goes something like that. Countered there. And Malik. Elbows to the jaw there. Getting out of whatever he got. But, oh! Rowling the double super kick. One to the knee, one to the jaw. Oh, Malik trying to fight back, but all he gets is a Gob and Gary for his troubles, my goodness. Malik was trying to regain his bearings, but it is not to be. Cole knocking him completely for a loop with that Gob and Gary, sending him tumbling to the thinly padded floor. Referee had a count of four here. Cole now looking to continue the onslaught, dropping him face first into the apron. Another count of seven. Cole realizing he's getting both men back into the ring here. Cole now waiting for Malik to get back to his feet. And now goes for the chop block! Completely taking out the leg of Malik Brown and now looking for the figure four leg lock. Malik far away from the ropes here. Cole with perfect positioning right now. Malik in a lot of trouble. Cole has been working over that leg ever since the beginning of this match, and now it is paying dividends. Malik Brown, a rock in a hard place, but still looking to reverse the pressure, looking to escape from the hold, and he does. Malik now has him. Oh, goodness, Calamity Trigger. The Calamity Trigger. And now he's in the corner. He could be looking for the Jaguar knee. There's the cutthroat. Nobody home. Oh, what a kick to the midsection. Cole now has him up. No, he doesn't. No, goodness, reverse DDT. I thought he might have had him after that super kick to the midsection, but Malik had enough wherewithal to get out of whatever the hell Cole was going for there. Now Malik coming back here. Bulldog, no! Couldn't get the Bulldog. Malik getting back to his feet. Super kick from out of nowhere from Cole. Will that be enough? No, Malik kicks out at the last possible second. Oh my goodness, the force that super kick had. And somehow, Malik is still in it. And now Cole has him up. There's the Ushigoroshi. This time, another pin. The two. And it's still not good enough. Malik Brown kicking out of Adam Cole's big maneuvers, but Cole still realizing he has some tools still left in his toolbox. Don't be looking for the Panama Sunrise. He's on the middle rope here. Malik slowly but surely trying to get back to his feet here. You can see he's kind of struggling, but Cole, he's looking for it. Oh, it's a double leg! Saw it coming! Swept him off the middle rope. Has him. No, he doesn't. Kick to the leg again. Damagiri missed this time. Kick to the leg. Oh, look at this. Malik returning the favor. Kick to the hamstring. Possibly another calamity trigger. No. Cole getting out of it. Big time forearm. He is just striking away at Malik now. Now what in the hell is this? Has a heat sinker! Heat sinker from Cole! Shoulders are down, but it gets the one shoulder up, and that's enough to break up the count. What a match this has been, as we kind of figured it would be. Cole again showing off the arrogance. Could be looking for that patella brain buster. No! Malik gets out of it. Sends him into the corner. Big time front kick! And another one! Malik now picking up Cole. Up on his shoulders. Oh, Jaguar rising! To the face, will that be enough? No, it will not! The Jaguar rising not being enough to put away Adam Cole. Now look at this, Cole going right back after the legs of Adam. Malik now looking for a reverse figure four. The trailer hitch is being applied here. And Adam Cole is looking for the ropes, but he can't seem to reach it. Oh, so he reverses the pressure and gets out of it. A quick escape there. Now Cole has him up. I don't even know in the world he has playing here. No. Malik getting out of that. Forearm. Big time kick to the head. That could have Oh my goodness, that absolutely dazed Cole. Malik is completely going in on Adam right now. Oh, Malik Brown. Looking for another dive here. Don't make a nobody home! Nobody home on the Toni and Io. And Adam Cole, Canadian Destroyer on the deadly padded floor, my goodness. That has to be it. That has to be all she got. All Cole has to do is get Malik in the ring, and this one's over. All he has to do is get him back in the ring. No, he's going to follow up. Patella Brainbuster! Puts the line. This one is not over! Cole feeling the effects of this match. Malik feeling the effects of this match. Both men still not going away here. Oh, Cole kissing Malik. That kiss goodbye could be looking for the boom. No. Malik though, German suplex. Still has him. Red Cord Lariat! And now, Malik. With Cole in his sights. Cole, oh, no. Could be looking for the connection. Then the super kick to the back of the head. corner. Pulled out. Kick to the leg. Has him set up. Panama Sunrise. Hooks the leg. Shoulders are down. This one is still not over. What in the world does Cole have to do? He's tried damn near everything, and Malik's still kicking out.
Oh, and now the referee having to check up on Malik. Seeing if he's able to, is still seeing if he's able to go. Malik's saying he's fine, but Cole is still on the attack, and now look at the stops, the desperate stops from Cole. Now just lining up Malik, waiting for him to get back to his feet. Oh my goodness, big time forearm. That one completely rocking Malik Brown, but look at this, Malik back to his feet, and look at this, look at his eyes, he wants more. Oh, and he got another one. But Malik, that's the heart of Malik Brown on display. That's the heart of the determination machine on full display. And Cole saying that you will fall, but no, Malik. Look at this, don't look at the strikes, the combination of strikes. Big time knee. Picking up Cole now. Has him up and down with the pile driver. Hooks the leg. Will that be enough? No, it will not. It will not be enough. Somehow, some way, Cole is still kicking. Cole is still fighting, but it couldn't be time. Jaguar now. Super kick. Followed up, Florida Keys! 1, 2, are you kidding me? What else is Cole going to have to do in order to get the pinfall? He's in the corner. He's waiting for Malik to get back to his feet. Oh, wait a minute! There's Pac! We mentioned Pac earlier, and now Pac popping up, causing a distraction for Cole here. Now look at this. Cole just daring Pac to do something now. He's daring him to hit him. Throwing him a little bit of a kiss. And I'll wait a second. Here comes Malik. Oh, wait a minute! Cole with the leapfrog! Malik and Pac, and now Cole with the boom! Malik hit Pac, but Cole hit Malik with the boom, and this one is over! Adam Cole with the 2-for-1 deal at the very end of that match. All thanks to Pac. Look at this. What an incredible match that was, though. Well, neither man willing to give it, but this is where the end of it. Malik was looking for the spear, but only caught Pac, and there was the boom. And because of Pac, Malik gets caught. Pac just inadvertently tossed Malik this match. But that's another victory for Adam Cole. And in doing so, he is completely one-upped Pac yet again. Adam Cole, baby, remains on top of the world at least for this episode of Destruction. Now, wait a minute! Pac! Not taking too kindly to being speared off the apron. Now taking all that anger out on Adam Cole. And now what? Oh, now he's looking for the brutalizer. The brutalizer getting locked in on Cole. The bastard completely going in on Adam Cole right now. There's not a damn thing anybody can do to stop him. He is choking the life out of Cole.
Now Pac has him set up. Looking for the Black Arrow, and he gets it. Just completely crushing Adam Cole with the Black Arrow, and now it is the Bastard standing tall by the end of episode number 5. Oh my god, this is so unfun! Jaguar Knee by Malik! And I don't think Malik's done! He had one for Pac, and now he's got another for Adam Cole! Malik might have not got the victory, but by the end, he's the only one still standing. And I think that this thing between both all three of these men has gotten out of hand.